This video accompanies the discussion of data basics in open interest statistics. Presenting and describing data is a first step in most analyses, and this video will provide us with some of the fundamental tools and terminology for getting started. We'll become familiar with observations, variables, and data matrices. We'll learn about different types of variables, including numerical and categorical variables, and we will have our first introduction to scatter plots and relationships between variables. Throughout, our focus will be on the county dataset, a publicly available dataset that summarizes economic and demographic information from 3,143 counties in the United States. This dataset contains information about each county, including its name, the state where it resides, its population in 2010, per capita federal spending, poverty rate, and several additional characteristics. The data matrix shown here presents some of this information. Data matrices are a convenient way to record and store data. Each row in the table represents a single county. We call these cases or observations. The columns represent characteristics, called variables, for each county. Fortunately, if another case is added to the dataset, an additional row can be easily included. Similarly, another column can be added for a new variable. Thinking about the variables in our county dataset, we can see some variables are inherently different from each other. The variable Fed Spend, federal spending per capita, is said to be a numerical variable since it can take a wide range of numerical values, and it is sensible to add, subtract, or take averages with those values. The POP 2010 variable, population in 2010, is also numerical, although it seems to be a little bit different than Fed Spend. POP 2010 can only take whole non-negative numbers, such as 0, 1, 2, and so on. For this reason, the population variable is said to be discrete, since it can only take numerical values with jumps. On the other hand, the federal spending variable is said to be a continuous numerical variable. The variable state, for state name, can take up to 51 values after accounting for Washington, D.C. Because the responses themselves are categories, state is called a categorical variable. Notice, even if we numbered the states, they would still be categorical because their average, sum, and difference would have no clear meaning. The figure summarizes the hierarchy of the different types of variables. Many analyses are motivated by a researcher looking for a relationship between two or more variables. For example, we might ask, is federal spending, on average, higher or lower in counties with high rates of poverty? Scatter plots are one type of graph used to study the relationship between two numerical variables. The figure helps us explore this question. Each point in the scatter plot represents a single county. For instance, the highlighted dot corresponds to county 1,088 in the county dataset, Owsley County, Kentucky, which had a poverty rate of 41.5% and federal spending of $21.50 per capita. The scatter plot suggests a relationship between the two variables. Counties with a high poverty rate also tend to have slightly more federal spending. We might brainstorm as to why this relationship exists and investigate each idea to determine which is the most reasonable explanation. If two variables are not associated, then they are said to be independent. That is, two variables are independent if there is no evident relationship between the two. Notice, a pair of variables are either related in some way, we call this associated, or not, which we call independent. In this video, we became familiar with observations, variables, and data matrices. We learned about different types of variables, and we had our first introduction to scatter plots and relationships between two variables. If you learned something you found interesting, share this video with a friend and visit openintro.org for more resources.